Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. Previously, we looked at the flow of the alpha channel through ConnectFX. This included matte inputs and outputs of nodes. So you should be able to work out where your alpha is and how it's being applied in the context of your composite. But there is always one node that has to be different. This time, it's the action node. This particular node does not have a constant number of outputs because you can have as many as you want. When you first load an action node, you will note that it only has one output. This output is usually your composite, or some refer to it as the beauty pass because it's your work of art. More seriously, when you go into an action composite, there may be more than one element you would like to output for further work. Take this composite for example. Here I have a background with some graphics composited on top of it. I would like to color correct the larger graphic behind the main one. There are many ways to do this in action, but I want to focus on the alpha channel in ConnectFX. Therefore, we need to get an alpha channel out of action, and the only way to do this is through the output menu. Here you can see that we have one output from action and the type is set to comp. This is the overall composite. To add a new output, click Add. A new output appears in the list and you can rename this to something reminding you that it is the alpha channel. Now select the result viewer. The reason why you select the viewer is when you start setting up the output, you will see the updates on the selected viewer. Select your new output in the list and change the type to matte. The screen will go black because you have not defined what will be in the alpha channel. You could click all objects and everything will be there, but it could get very messy if you have many objects in the composite. I prefer to use the action schematic to see all my objects and choose what I need. All the nodes are grayed out because nothing is selected. Change the cursor mode to edit output. Now just tap on the nodes and they will start highlighting and appearing in the matte viewer. Now here we have a problem. The graphic we want to color correct is sitting behind the other graphic that I don't want to color correct. So I would like to exclude the front graphic from the alpha. In the object list, you can read that both objects are visible. Just select the front graphic and change its mode to occlude only. The front graphic is now cutting a hole through the graphic that excludes it from the alpha. Now we can take this output and color correct it further. Press the home icon to return to the main ConnectFX and the ConnectFX viewer. Looking at the action node, you can see that it now has two outputs. The second blue output is the alpha channel from the output menu. I'll drag a color warper node from the ConnectFX node bin and connect it into the branch after the action node. So we'll use this color warper node to do the selective color correction on the graphic. For selective color correction, we need a foreground, the same image as the background, and the matte. So we have taken the same image from the composite, isolated it with the alpha, and recomposited it back on itself. In the color warper, I'll do a basic grade to show you how this workflow can work for you. I have one last tip before we move on to the next video. I am sure that you've deduced that you can have more than two outputs from action. However, the current visual representation of the action node can only show a maximum of two outputs. If you add any more outputs into action, the output of the node will go gray. So in order for you to see more than two outputs coming out of an action node, press Ctrl+C. This will maximize the action node and all the outputs will be exposed with their names so you can identify the correct pass you are after. In the next video, I'll briefly touch on straight alpha and pre-multiplied alpha. I'll also point out a few techniques to get around some of the common issues caused by these types. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.